Hello dear students, we are back with our physics lecture. We have started the lesson electricity and its circuit. This lesson is there in the class CBSE book, 6th standard CBSE book. In the last video we have discussed about the cell. See, this is a cell. The cell whichever you are getting in the market is of different forms. It is like this. This is a battery. Okay, now what is a battery, that we will discuss in the next video. Okay, so first we are going to learn, in today's video we are going to discuss the next component, electric component, that is electric bulb. Which component we are going to discuss today? Electric bulb. Now what is electric bulb? Electric bulb or a torch bulb has an outer case made up of glass that is fixed on a metallic base. Let us know the internal structure of the bulb. Now see what they have told. The electric bulb consists of, the outer case consists of glass. This is a glass, okay, and it is fixed on the metallic base. See, this is a metallic base. Can you see this? Now the next point is, a thin wire that gives off light is called filament of the bulb. Now which is the thin wire which gives off the light? Now see, can you see here a wire, the thin wire? Yes, this is a filament. This is what it is called. It is called a filament of the bulb which gives a light. So what is the main use of this electric bulb? It gives us light. Am I right? So a thin wire that gives off light is called as a filament of the bulb. So this is called as a filament of the bulb. It is made up of tungsten. The which material it is made up of? This wire is made up of which material? It is made up of tungsten and is fixed to two thick wire that gives support to it. Now where are the two fixed wire? Can you see here two fixed wire? See, this is a filament and these are the two wires which give support to this filament. Are you getting? Which gives support to it. Okay. One of this thick wire is connected to the metal case at a base of the bulb. Are you getting? It is connected to the base of the bulb. Now see, one of this wire is connected to the base, of this metallic base. Are you getting? The outer thick wire is connected to the metal tip at the center of the base. Now see, the one of this wire is connected to directly to this base, and outer wire is connected to the center of this base. Are you getting this? The metal tip at the center of the base and metal case at its lower end acts as a terminal of the bulb. So these two act as a terminal of the bulb. Are you getting? So these two terminal of the bulbs are fixed in a such a way that they do not touch each other. Now see, can you see these? Whether they are very too close to each other? No, they are not too close to each other. They are away from each other. Are you getting? When an electric current is passed through the filament of the bulb, the filament becomes hot and glows. Now, when we on the switch, switch is also the one kind of electric component. When we on this switch, can you see this filament? This is a filament which, when the current passes, it becomes hot. This tungsten wire becomes hot and it starts to glow. Are you getting this? So this is how the working of the electric bulb. If you join the two terminal of the electric cell without connecting them through the switch and a device like a bulb, the chemical in the electric cell get used by up very fast. As a result, the cell stop working soon. Now see, this is a cell. Yes or no? What is this? This is a cell. Now sometimes we say that a cell is not working properly. Why is it so? Because in the cell, now we have learned the different types of the cell. Yes or no? In that we have learned there are the two types, means one is act as an anode, another it act as a cathode, and in that there is a chemical. Once the chemical is get finished, this cell is of no use. This cell is of no use. So we have to replace this cell. Are you getting? Now how is the connection is done? Now in the way the different types of connections are given. Now see, if you will see this connection, the positive wire is connected to the upper case, means here, and the second, the negative wire is connected to the lower case of the bulb. Are you getting? So there are some activities which are given in your book, that is you can go through this activity, and they have shown the different connection of the bulb. See how to use the connection of the bulb. Are you getting? These are the different activities. If you will not connect the wire properly, then the bulb will not glow. Are you getting this? So this is how the connection is done. Now if you will connect both the terminal to the one point of the cell, that is if you will connect this to the two wires will be connected to the same point, that is negative point, whether the bulb will glow? No, the bulb will not glow at all. If you will connect both the point to the positive terminal, then also the bulb will not glow. If the wire is broken, then also the bulb will not glow. Are you getting? So the bulb should be connected properly. These are the some cases which is given in your science textbook. Then the next type of the electric component we are going to discuss, that is electric circuit. Now we are going to discuss about the electric circuit. Now what is actually the circuit? Now see, we have done here the connection, am I right? We have used a cell, then we have used a wire and bulb. This is how we have connected, am I right? So this connection is called as, in a short we say, it is a nothing but electric circuit. Are you getting? Electric circuit. The bulb glows only when there is a flow of electricity. Now when only, if the cell is not there, can the bulb will glow? No, the bulb will glow only when there is a flow of electricity. The flow of electricity is also called as electric current. Now we have learned in the introduction only I have told you what is the electricity and what is the electric current, am I right? So when we connect one terminal of the cell to the another terminal of the cell through the bulb, we create a closed path and the bulb glows. The path along which the electric current can flow is called as an electric circuit or a circuit. When the circuit is completed, the electric current flows through the circuit. This circuit is called as a closed circuit. Now can you see, this is a circuit? Are you getting? This is a circuit, electric circuit. Now when we can say it is a complete circuit, when we join the particular path, that is a positive terminal is connected to this bulb and negative is terminal connected to this bulb, and when the current will pass, and always remember, the current always flow from the positive terminal towards the negative terminal. The current always flow from the positive terminal to the negative terminal. Are you getting this? So what is in that? The flow of the current is always on. When we can say it is a complete circuit or a closed circuit, when the connection is done properly and when the bulb will glow, that time only we can say the circuit is complete or a closed circuit, or it is called as a closed circuit. Are you getting? Now in this we are also going to learn the next component of the, for the electric circuit we need, that we are going to discuss. Okay, the cell, the bulb and the connecting wires are all the parts of the electric circuit. Sometimes an electric bulb does not glow even if the connected to the cell. This may happens if the bulb is fused. Now what is meant by the fused? Can you just tell me what is meant by the fused? So what is meant by the fused? This happens if the bulb is fused. Now what is exactly the fuse? Now can you see this filament? If it is broken, then we can say it is see this wire is also there. If it is broken somewhere, then we can say the bulb is fused, means it will not work properly or it will not glow. Are you getting this? So therefore this may happen if the bulb is fused. An electric bulb may fuse due to many reasons. Now there are the different reasons where this bulb can get fused. Now what are that reasons? See, we will just go through it. One reason for the bulb to get fused is a breakage in its filament. Now only just I have told you, see, there is a break. If the breakage in the filament, then the bulb will then we can say the bulb is fused. Are you getting this? The breakage in the filament means a break in the path of the electric circuit between the terminal of the electric cell. Therefore, a fused bulb does not glow as no current passes through its filament. Now see, what exactly it is? See, this is a filament. If there is a breakage in this filament, then the bulb will not glow. Are you getting? So this is, in today's video we have learned about the two types of electric component, that is bulb and how to connect the circuit. And when we are connecting the circuit, that circuit is called as a electric circuit. And one more point, that the current always flow from positive terminal towards the negative terminal. Are you getting? Have you understood these two points? Now we will move to the next component of the electricity, that is electric switch. We are going to go through the next component, that is electric switch. Now what is exactly the switch? Now see, when you are feeling very hot, then you turn on a button, am I right? You turn on the button, that is called as a switch. Are you getting? So what is an electric switch? That we will see. An electric switch is a simple device that is used to open or close an electric circuit. It is a simple device. Now button is nothing but it is a switch. It is used to on and off. Are you getting? If the circuit is on, then the current will flow, then only the fan will move, am I right? So like that, or the bulb will glow. If the circuit is closed, or if the switch is off, then the current will not flow, am I right? The bulb will not glow. Are you getting? So what is exactly the electric switch, that we will discuss. Now switches comes in a various shapes and a size. Sometimes a switch is also referred to as a key in an electric circuit. Switch is also called as a key. Now here, if the key is closed, means when you on the button, means your circuit is complete, am I right? Then only the bulb will glow. Are you getting? And if the switch is open, or when you turn off the lights, then when you switch off the button, at that time the circuit is open, the switch is open, then the current will not flow. Are you getting? The current will not flow. So this is the closed circuit and this is the open circuit. Are you getting? So this, what is this? These are the symbols. Are you getting? So what are the symbol, electric symbols, that we will see in the next video. Are you getting? So we will just go through this. When the key is closed, the electric circuit is complete. When the key is closed and the electric circuit is complete. Are you getting? When the circuit is closed, or when the switch is closed, then only the bulb will glow. Or when the switch is open, then the bulb will not glow. So in today's video we have discussed the three components of the electric circuit, that is first is a bulb, then we have discussed about electric circuit, then we have discussed about switch. In the next video we will discuss about the symbols. Now see, you have seen the these type of this lines. What is this? This is a nothing but cell. This is a key. Are you getting? So in the next video we will discuss about the electric symbols. Are you getting it? I hope you have understood it. Just go through this and read once again, and if you have doubt you can ask me. Thank you.